come join us?
Okay, so I just want to welcome everyone and thank you very much for coming. Some of you I know, some of you I don't know. This is the first science cafe that I'm planning, and hopefully this is the first of many. It's just part of a dream I've had of having this kind of space in Brantford where we can discuss not just science but a host of other issues. And I want to thank Frank and Martha for letting us use their space. And Frank and Martha.
Thank you, Madam Speaker.
And also, of course, Gordon, who's our first presenter for this series. I'm looking upon it as a series. And Gordon is going to talk to us about industrial ecology. I have some sign-up sheets in case anyone wants to be on my email list, and I have great hopes for this, so there will be many more cafes. The next one actually is already set. It's on the 24th of January, and Tom Pollard, who's a cell biologist in Yale, will be talking to us about issues related to cell movement and related stuff. I'll be sending out flyers. Sorry?
Who are you?
Oh, I am Deepthi Pradhan. And a lover of science and the world. I'm passionate about a lot of issues, and I hope to bring them into this forum, which we hope to sustain in Brantford. Thank you. Go on.
So first, the sound test. Can you hear me back there? Okay, if I start mumbling, someone wake me up, okay? I'm going to try and do this interactively. The youngsters have already promised that they will shout out a lot of answers, but you oldsters, don't be shy also. I think it'd be fun to have this a little bit more as a discussion than as a lecture.
Yeah, that's the plan.
Right, okay. So first, let me introduce myself just briefly. My name is Gordon Jabal. I live in the Stony Creek part of Brantford, so I'm a Brantfordite. I met this young lady, Deepthi, because we both serve on something called the Brantford Education Foundation, which is an organization of Brantford people and donors who are trying to provide some extra resources for the teachers in the Brantford public schools. And as you already heard, because of her starting this up, this is the first one, Deepthi's like a fountain of creative energy and a fountain of energy. So who knows what she'll have us all doing next, but this I think is going to be really fun. I'm an ecologist by training. I got my PhD at Yale University as a plant physiologist. So we're going to start out sort of in the natural world, looking at the word ecology. And then I want to introduce a thing that I think might sort of be an eye-opener to you, that we put the words industry and ecology together. And that's sort of the oxymoron, although I'm going to try to prove to you that it's really not. And I want to sort of show you how those two things come together. I have a handout at the end that has a couple of web links, so you can go back home and do some more searching on this if you want. So, briefly, how many of you are like to walk in the woods or members of the Land Trust or have a garden out back or whatever? Okay, good. So, you guys, we're the ecologists of the group, okay? You know that being outside, even without training, scientific training like a PhD, you start to really learn and observe what's going on. So for instance, so I said to you, as you're walking through the woods, do you ever see waste? Do you ever see something that, what you would call that waste? Now you might see somebody's gum wrapper, I'm not talking about that. If you're walking through a clean woods, do you ever see something called waste? Well, those of you who garden and those of you, you may have weeds, you might have things that we think don't belong there, but there's never such a thing as waste in ecology. Everything always gets used. Okay, so that's the main part of ecology that I want you to bring. There's lots else, and I'm going to illustrate it in one way, okay? This fall, when the leaves died and fell off the tree, the leaves that fell aren't called waste, okay? Because what happens? The worms start eating the leaves, the insects burrow under, the squirrels make nests. The leaves get used in lots of ways, and in the spring, they'll decay, and the chemicals that are in them will go into the soil, and the roots from the plants will start taking those nutrients up again, and they'll be returned to plants and shrubs and be used for the growth of the new leaves. Or they might be used, some of the chemicals will be used to make seeds, the birds will eat the seeds, the birds will fly away, some of the seeds will fall, new plants will grow. So those of you who've worked in a garden know that everything sort of continues on. So if you jump from that to our world, the human world, we have the word waste. That's an easily understandable waste. So who wants to give us some examples of waste? What's something that you throw away that's waste? Yeah, sure. Cardboard cup, plastic cup, straw. He's going to throw three things away. What else do you throw away? Where's my other bubble here? What do you throw away?
Food.
Food, right. You don't clean your whole plate? You don't eat the plate? Okay, let's say there's a pan of bird pasta, and you throw that away. There's lots of examples. Paper we throw away. Now, many of us, especially in Brantford, in the state of Connecticut, are now doing something called recycling. So some of what used to be waste, like newspapers, now it's not thrown away anymore. Okay? So that's, you see where industrial ecology is going to go? That's an example of industrial ecology. The lesson of my story is we're trying to move our society, the human society, away from this concept of waste. And we're trying to get to a process where every single thing is used in some way. Okay, so let me illustrate that. There's a very famous town in Denmark called Kalundborg. It's actually not very famous because probably none of you have heard about it, but in the industrial ecology world it's very famous.
What's the name of it?
Kalundborg. That's not the Danish pronunciation, so if anybody from Denmark wants to correct, I heard it recently and I tried to learn how to pronounce it correctly, but I didn't. In Kalundborg, there's an industrial park, like we have, say, at Exit 56 here in Brantford, or a typical industrial park. But what's happened is 15 different companies that are located in the park use the waste of one company as an input to some process of another company. So, for instance, there's a power plant that burns oil. And instead of the excess steam just going up the top of the power plant, that steam's actually diverted and it heats the municipal swimming pool, okay? So the coal is burned and it's made electricity, but that's not 100% efficient. Some of the heat's left and it goes up the stack, but instead of that just going into the atmosphere, that heat is used in another sense. The ash from burning the coal goes to the plant that's making wallboard, and it's mixed in part, I don't know the chemistry of it, but it's part of the process of making wallboard. So the power plant now has almost no waste anymore that it's created. And that's similar then for all these other industries. One of them is a farm, one of them is a fish farm. So some of the food waste, for instance, gets composted, and that compost goes to a farm and gets turned into the soil and helps grow the plants. So you can see that it gets to be sort of fun to try to play this game. Gardeners often do this. So you have leaves in your garden, and you don't know what to do with them. Lots of people pack them up and they go to the landfill, but you sort of say, wow, this is a pretty cool resource. What can I do with it? And you can make a compost heap in your backyard, or you can dig them in if you get somebody to dig them into the soil for you. So I'm trying to show you now what industrial ecology means. It means that for all of the processes that we have in our world, now, you'll see on some of the websites that the word industry here I'm using in a funny way. So the word industry can be used in the sense of manufacturing, but, you know, somebody who works really hard is industrious, right? So industry can also be sort of thought of as sort of anything that humans do. So I'm using it in that more general sense. So even though you might not think you're in an industrial plant, we're not in a manufacturing plant in this Sweet Bear, is that the name of this place?
Yes.
We should get Sweet Bear on TV, a little free advertising.
Yes.
So we're all sitting here in Sweet Bear, having our coffee and milkshakes and beautiful pastries. We don't think of it as an industrial plant, but we can look at it as an industrial ecologist would. So now we're going to get to the participation part.